Hello, this is Tattoo Tony with another adventure. I've searched for every neglected, abandoned, grimy, and interesting piece of our past for us to explore. Please enjoy today's show.
Hey guys, this is Tattoo Tony, and welcome back to this short video of a Thomas Hart Benton mural in the Missouri State Capitol. I filmed this the same day that I filmed a video of the outside of the old Walls Prison in Jefferson City. In any ways, in 1936, the most famous Missouri artist, Thomas Hart Benton, climbed on top of scaffolding and painted a 40-foot-long mural in the House Lounge of the Missouri Capitol. It's a room where members of the House of Representatives retreat when not conducting business. It was very hot when he painted this. It was the Dust Bowl years, and it was one of the hottest summers on record, and it was also one of the driest on record. There was at least 37 days of triple-digit temperatures in Missouri. The heat was blazing. He used egg tempura as his medium of choice. Think about mixing all those egg yolks with pigment in the heat. Pretty crazy. In any case, I also read that he was paid about $16,000 back in 1936, which is the equivalent of about $400,000 today, in today's money. In the late 90s, they had this mural valued, or what do you call that? Anyways, had an estimate done on its worth, and they said it was worth about $10 million. All the people in the mural are people that he found in the state of Missouri and studied and drew sketches of and made clay figures of the scenes and studied the light to see how it played off the figures. But anyways, Thomas Hart Benton, his father was Maecenas, I believe. I can't pronounce him. Benton, who came to Missouri in 1869 from Tennessee. He was a lawyer who served as a U.S. attorney, state representative, and was elected to terms in the U.S. House. The artist was named for his father's great-uncle, Senator Thomas Hart Benton, who was one of Missouri's first two U.S. senators in the early 1800s. As a child, Benton and his siblings went back and forth with their parents from Missouri to Washington, D.C. When his father served in Congress, Benton rejected life as a lawyer or politician because he loved to draw. His interest in art was encouraged by his mother, and she financially supported him while he went to art school. We're just taking a look at this room here. It's pretty cool. So Benton dropped out of high school at the age of 17 and started working as a cartoonist for the Joplin American newspaper. His mother, Elizabeth Wise Benton, again was supportive, but Benton's father enrolled him in the Western Military Academy in Alton, Illinois. Wow. In 1906, before agreeing to allow him to attend the Art Institute of Chicago in 1907, the following year Benton traveled to Paris and studied at the Académie Julian. I'm probably not saying that right. There he met California artist Stanton McDonald Wright and began to experiment with McDonald Wright's synchromist style of abstract painting. In 1911, he returned to the United States and settled in New York. He taught briefly at the Chelsea Neighborhood Association, where he met his future wife, Rita Piacenza, one of his students. During World War I, Benton served at the Naval Base in Norfolk, Virginia, where he made illustrations for a catalog of ships and military equipment. After the war, Benton went back to New York, and in 1922, he was married. The couple was married for 53 years and had two children. They regularly spent summers on Martha's Vineyard, Massachusetts. Benton's work until the early 1920s was generally modernist and often abstract. In 1924, however, Benton traveled to Missouri to see his sick father. Returning home to his state inspired him to reclaim his Midwestern roots and break with modernism, focusing instead on American rural subjects such as life in steel mills, logging camps, coal mines, cotton fields. Because of his leftist political leanings, he championed working class people and represented them as heroes in his paintings and murals. Benton began to paint in a naturalistic style that was influenced by the Spanish master El Greco, and he became known as the most innovative practitioner of mural painting in a decade of great importance for this medium in America. He completed monumental mural cycles for the New School for Social Research, the Whitney Museum of Art, and the 1933 Chicago World's Fair, all of which aroused controversy because of their political content. By December 24, 1934, when Benton became the first artist to have work, featured on the cover of the Time magazine, he was regarded as one of the three leading American regionalist painters, along with Grant Wood. I hope you guys enjoyed those facts. I think the Alton tie is very interesting, that he was enrolled to go to military school here, which is also the same school that Buck O'Hare went to, Military Academy, who the O'Hare Airport in Chicago is named after, and also, I think he was on the flight or the pilot that dropped one of the H-bombs. But in any case, hope you guys enjoyed this video. Thomas Hart Benton's artwork is very cool. I like it. It's very interesting. I really like the style. And just wanted to share that with you guys because I had filmed it, you know, a few years ago. And just thought I might as well put it up. Hope you enjoyed. Please like, subscribe, and share.